The Bible is the only book which says Jesus is cursed. In Galatians chapter 3 verse 13. And it says, the devil is the lord of the world. In the Quran is the other way around. Allah is the lord of the world and Satan is cursed. And that's why before we start reading the Quran, we say, A'udhu billahi minash shaitani rajim. Which means, we seek refuge in the Satan who is cursed. Okay? Okay? And this guy here, Jason, he keeps harassing people. He keeps running after them. And he can't answer the questions we're asked. So anyway, this is the point. Right now, no wonder the churches are getting empty on a daily basis. By the way, Jason,
you're full of hate, sir.
Jason, if you or your friend here,
if you talk to know me any church, if you talk to
do you know, if you know
police,
any church that is empty,
said,
please let us know because we need masjid.
It just says,
we need to build
masjid. It just says, if I follow him, he'll follow the police.
Which are empty.
Don't follow me.
The churches are empty.
Who's following you? I was actually talking to you. You got it in.
So anyway, why is he running away now? Because he knows the truth has been revealed. And the falsehood is exposed. Yo, come here. Come here if you challenge me. Come here.
Come and debate, bro.
You see, this is what happens.
Hashim.
You said, look at this guy, man. Of all the people, the Jason will be the last one I'll debate. Not because he's knowledgeable.
I've got it. Look.
Calm down.
I've got it, bro.
Calm down.
There it is, bro.
Calm down.
What's the scholar?
I don't want to talk about the scholar.
What's the scholar?
I don't want to talk about no scholar with you.
That's what. Come on, bro, Muslim scholar, bro. Look at him.
So what? Okay. Can you tell me why Jesus is cursed?
Muslim scholar.
No, why Jesus has been cursed?
Why?
Let's talk about this.
Okay, let's talk about this. 3:13, it says Jesus is cursed. Why? Why is your God cursed?
Let's talk about this.
He won't answer the question. So anyway, this is the reason they don't answer the question. Because they come here daily, they chase us to answer. When we ask, they don't answer. Anyway, don't change the topic. My topic was, why is Jesus in the Bible cursed? Why is my prophet supposed to be cursed in the Bible? And we respect Jesus. We call him Isa alayhi salam. Isa, peace be upon him.
And he said,
we do not say he's cursed. Only the Bible says he's cursed.
And he said,
why?
I don't know Arabic. And I said, I've got Muslim scholars.
I will give you the verse. It's in Galatians chapter 3, verse 13. Go and check it out.
So what was your question? So repeat your question back to him.
My question is,
he did not die. Why does he need to resurrect? I don't. Was that? No, no,
it's not the same belief in
him. Exactly. So it's not the same.
Hashim,
do you believe Jesus is cursed?
Hashim,
do you believe Jesus is cursed?
Hashim,
what if I show you in your Bible that is cursed? You won't believe it? No? So you're not a Christian?
Why not? It's not right.
Yes, you are. It's not the same.
If you are a Christian,
I'm allowed to heckle.
I'm allowed to what you're saying. You are stating.
Why didn't you prove me wrong?
Because you are stating that you believe in Jesus, right? In the Quran, Isa, right or wrong?
Yes.
But Isa is not Jesus.
Who said that? Who said that he's not Jesus?
Because the whole purpose of Jesus was he was resurrected. In the Quran, was he resurrected? In the Quran, was he resurrected? Yes or no?
No. No. I already answered that question. Did I not?
It was Itijen, God, replaced him with who?
Are you a...
God replaced him with who?
Do you believe in God? You believe in God?
The Quran says God replaced him with who? The Quran says he was replaced by who? Jesus.
Who is your? I think you should read the Quran before you make accusations.
So what happened to Jesus?
In the Quran.
Who is he replaced by?
Can I answer the way I want? No, yes and no. And after that, you answer my question.
No, no, I'm asking a question. It says, Jesus, what happened to him?
I will answer my
was Jesus crucified?
I will answer.
Was Jesus crucified?
I will answer.
Go ahead.
I will answer. It's only fair after you answer your question, you allow me to ask you a question. Is that fair? Yes? Yes?
Yes,
okay, so Jesus, according to the Quran, was neither killed nor crucified. Okay? You're saying because of that, is not the same Jesus. Let me ask you this. 30 million Arabs called Allah, God called God Allah. Are we talking about the same Allah?
No.
Exactly. That's how it works. You see, they call the same name Allah to God Almighty. 30 million Arab Christians and many Jews who are Arabs and many other people who are non-Muslims, they call God Allah.
That's correct.
Okay? It's just how they perceive God, this Allah, that is the difference. For example, you believe, you're a Christian, I'm assuming? Yeah? You believe that God incarnated as a man and he died by his own creation.
That's what the Bible
right?
says. Yeah.
We Muslims do not believe that or even the Jews actually don't believe that God can either become a man or die.
That's right.
So from the Abrahamic faiths, the Christians are the odd ones out.
That's right.
You see what I mean? The Jews and the Muslims do not believe God can become a man, or he can die by his own creation, or by anyone, let alone. But the Christians believe that he not only became a man, but he was also killed. He was stripped naked, humiliated, and killed by his own creation. Now, which one makes sense to you? God dying by his own creation, or God who is immortal, as the Bible affirms?
He was the sacrifice. That's what you're not understanding. He was the lamb, the sacrificial lamb. That's what you're not understanding.
But was he God?
That's who he was, God incarnate on earth.
Okay, so if he was God, can God die?
Did he die though? See, that's the thing. You guys do not agree that he was resurrected.
No, I as a Muslim.
That's the whole point.
Hold on.
He shows that there is life after death.
No, hold on. Right? I didn't say he ceased to exist. I never said that. The question was, did he die? Was Jesus mortal or immortal? Well, if he died according to your belief, then he is immortal. You see, one day you will die, one day I will die.
That's not what it is. We're not talking about the mortal coil. The whole focus of Jesus was about the spirit, not about the mortal coil.
I think you're missing the point. I'm not asking why he died. All I'm asking so far is, did he die? Because according to 1 Timothy 6:16, it says he alone is immortal. Who? God.
That's right.
He alone is immortal, whom no man hath seen or can see.
That's right.
Does this passage apply to Jesus Christ?
Was he resurrected or not?
Yes, he was.
Right.
According to your belief.
Right.
Okay.
Not according to yours.
No, not because he never died.
So he's not the same guy. Keep saying we believe in Jesus. No.
No. You're,
what if somebody said we believe in Muhammad, but we do not believe all the things that it says? He cut the moon in half. He rode it, and we don't believe in any of this stuff. Then what do you say? But we believe in Muhammad.
Shall I say why you're missing the point? Just one sec. No, I know what you're trying to get at.
It's not the same guy.
No, it's not about the same guy. It's what your Bible says, and what you actually believe. So your Bible, I'm not using the Quran here. I'm using 1 Timothy chapter 6:16. Clearly states God is immortal. You believe Jesus is God, but he died. That is contradicting this statement. And I'm not using the Hadith or the Quran here. So you cannot say not the same guy. I'm talking about the same guy Jesus mentioned in your Bible.
And I told you the focus was not on the body. The focus is on the soul, the spirit. That's what you're not understanding.
What about the soul?
You're reading into things.
Okay, what about the soul? Tell me, what about the soul?
You're reading into it.
What about the soul?
What do you mean, what about the soul?
You said the focus is not on the human, but on the soul. What do you mean by the soul?
The soul is immortal.
Is your soul immortal?
Of course.
Is your soul immortal?
You tell me. It seems like you have an answer for me. Go ahead.
Yes, you tell me. He gave his point. I'm sure you can give your point.
Go for it.
Okay, so your soul will live on either eternal bliss or eternal damnation.
Well,
which means this. Which means your soul doesn't cease to exist. Yes, and it'll carry on after you die. Okay, the whole purpose of what death is, basically, the definition of death is, means the soul separates from the body. Did that happen to Jesus according to the Christian belief? Yes, it did. Hence, he died. Hence, the resurrection.
How do you know it's separated? The body wasn't even there when they went back.
The body wasn't there?
No.
So wait a minute. Who died on the cross?
You tell me.
You're the one disagreeing. I'm not the one. You're the one disagreeing.
Doesn't make any sense.
So you said he was a sacrifice.
That's right.
So who sacrificed?
He himself.
No. Who sacrificed on the cross?
Jesus.
So he died.
Yes.
So why are you all disputing your own argument? I don't know.
I'm not disputing the own
argument. You said...
You're the one who's stating you believe in Isa, and Isa is Jesus, and you say this to make others believe, okay, we believe in the same God. No.
I never said we believe in one God, but
that
your perception...
That is the intention of what you are saying.
No, don't tell me what my intention was.
Yes.
Ask me.
Because the whole...
You don't know my intention.
The whole Christian faith is based upon the fact that God was incarnate as God, as Jesus, and then sacrificed himself on the cross for everyone else. That's the whole basic
exactly my point. So that basis,
by stating that you believe in Isa, but he did not die on the cross, then you may as well say that doesn't even exist.
You already answered your own question. You said you Muslims believe this, and we Christians believe this.
Correct.
So you see, we are talking about the same man with two different point of views. It's still the same man, Jesus.
Right.
Just like Allah is still the same Allah, but Christians call him Allah. The Jews call him Allah. I'm talking about the Arab Christians, Arab Jews. Yes. And the Muslims call him Allah. It's still the same Allah, but your point of view differs from my point of view.
It's not the same Allah. It's not the same Allah.
Do you call God Allah? You're an Arab Christian, I'm assuming?
That's a word, Allah. It's just a word in terms of other Jews.
Okay.
Okay, I'm clueless.
No. Whether it's semantics or not, we are talking about Allah.
Semantics. No, but who though? Him, me?
How am I dealing with semantics? The Arabs do call him Allah. Do they not?
They use it as God. It doesn't mean it's the same God that's in the Quran though.
Wait a minute. I said the point of view of the Quran about God and the point of view about God, in the Bible, are two different.
Dajjal, the greatest deceiver. The greatest deceiver.
Who is the Dajjal? Dajjal is Antichrist.
No, no, no. The greatest deceiver is who?
Dajjal.
Who is the greatest deceiver?
Dajjal.
No, they say about Allah himself, he is the greatest of deceivers.
That's a lie.
No, it isn't. Yes, it is.
You're talking about, the words, Yam Kuruna, Yam Kurullah, Allah Khairul Makirin.
It's right in there.
No, it means Allah plans, not deceives. Allah plans and they plan. And Allah is the best of planners. So please do not misinterpret, because you saw it from some anti-Islamic, Islamophobic website. By the way,
what do you mean Islamophobic? What does Islamophobic even mean?
It means someone who's anti-Islam.
And what does that mean, anti-Islam?
Means they have prejudice towards the Muslims.
Why?
Ask them.
Why?
Ask them.
Why?
Ask them.
Why?
Are you saying there are no people who hate Islam?
What are the three options for the non-believers?
Stop changing the topic.
What? No, you are. What's Islamophobic?
I asked you about Jesus. You're putting all red herrings here and there.
No.
Why don't you let me finish my point?
What are the three? I'm continuing your point.
No, you're not.
What are the three?
My point was, did Jesus die?
What are the three options for the kafar? What are the three?
Okay, that's another topic.
What are the three options for the kafar? What are the three options?
Alright.
You want to change the topic?
What are the three options?
You want to change the topic?
What are the three options?
Do you want to change the topic?
Who here knows what the three options are?
I know the three options.
Then go ahead.
Okay, I will go ahead.
What are the three options?
I will go ahead. Provided you finish, let me finish the topic.
What are the three options?
Let me finish the topic.
What are the three options?
Let me finish the topic.
You throw a word, some of these people may leave. You throw
the Nobody's leaving. Is anyone leaving?
What are the three options?
Okay.
What are the three options?
I will give you the answer.
Go for
Why are you so militant about that?
Because you're dancing around it.
I'm not dancing. I'm standing here.
What are the three options?
Why the ad hominems?
What are the three?
Because you can't answer my point.
I'm not attacking you.
You are. You said
no.
I'm dancing.
No.
You're not talking about the topic.
Three options. What are the three? That's not red herrings.
Okay. It is red herrings. You know why?
Incorrect. Because you throw Islamophobia. Stop your bullshit. What are the three options?
Why did you get so offended when I said
because
about Islamophobia?
Because you're the one accusing me of bullshit. So what are the
three options? Did I say you speak bullshit?
Yes. What are the three options?
When did I say you speak bullshit?
Red herrings.
Red herrings is not bullshit.
Yes,
look it up in the dictionary.
Friend. Yes, it is.
No, I'm changing the topic.
What are the three options?
Because when you give too many
what
different
are the three options?
I'll give you the three options.
What are the three options?
Okay, I'll give you the three options.
No.
Then you'll respond to my question.
What are the three options for non-believers?
To my question.
What is it?
I'll give you.
What is it?
Will you then answer my question?
What are the three options?
I will. Will you then answer?
It depends what the question is.
You see what I mean? Well, I also have the choice. Depends on what questions.
Fine. Okay, the three options are for the non-believers, as written within the Quran, the Hadith, and what else? What are the three options?
What you're saying? Tell me.
It says convert, pay the jizya, or death.
That's false.
That's not false.
That's false. Shall
That's
I correct
not
you?
False. And the jizya is available to who?
Shall I correct you?
The jizya is available to who?
Okay, anyway.
To people.
The
of
three
Islam.
Options.
No, so he wants to quiet me.
Yeah, right, because I already know.
The jizya is all
you know,
available.
You know this?
The jizya is available to the people of the book who are who?
I will come to jizya as well.
The people
no
of the
problem.
Book
you're wrong.
Are the
no,
people of the Bible.
No problem.
So that would I've be the come. Jews and Christians. So people who are not Jews and Christians, that option is not available.
You know one option you
so
forgot?
So that means conversion or death.
Yeah.
So you tell me about Islamophobia now.
Yes, I will.
Okay.
If you let me speak.
It's not false, okay. Guys.
First,
it's in the book.
Wait. First and foremost, the three options he gave are only partially correct. Yes, it is if they convert to Islam, this is in the context of war. So once they have been subdued in a war, these are the options they get. They get the option to convert to Islam and live and
okay.
In the land.
Dar al-Islam with Dar al-Salam.
Can I finish without interrupting? Can I finish without interrupting? I know you're a very impatient man and you're very agitated because I said Islamophobic.
Because you're dancing.
No, I'm not dancing. I'm correcting your question. So the first option is yes, they can convert to Islam and they can live peacefully with the Muslims. The second option they are given is to pay the jizya, like he said. Yes?
A tax, extortion.
No, the tax which was imposed on the Muslims is called zakat.
Right.
The tax which is imposed on the Ahli Kitab, like you rightfully said, and only on the males, the jizya is only applicable on the males. Those who
because
can afford
they
it.
The bread earners back then.
Can I finish? No. And those who can afford it, and those that jizya actually exempts them from military duty. Look at the zakat. Zakat is imposed on
it
the male.
From military wait, duty because that's
convenient. Wait a minute. Zakat on the other hand, zakat on the other hand is imposed on the Muslims, those who can afford it, yes? And it's on both males and females, not like the jizya, only the males. The third thing is even if they are paid the zakat, they still are not exempt from the military duty. So you tell me who's better off.
Exactly.
Alhamdulillah, that's the beauty of Islam. Now you said something else about
who's better off?
The Muslims.
Who's better
Sorry,
off?
Sorry, the non-Muslims in this state.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Because they're forced to pay a tax.
Okay, are you saying someone living in a country should not pay tax?
And what happens if they choose not to pay the tax?
Are you a tax avoider?
What if they
are
say
you a tax avoider?
What if yeah, here
you avoid tax?
The tax? No. Thank you. Are you happy with that option? Are you happy with that option? And then the option is
so how is it unfair? How is it unfair? I want to know.
That
the option is not locked up. The option is not locked up. He told you the option.
Wait, wait, wait. The option is not death.
You said the option.
You said the option is death. No, that's false. I never said. If you don't pay the jizya, it's not death. That is absolutely wrong. In fact, if you don't pay the zakat, what did Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu do?
Exactly.
Yes, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he waged war on the Muslims because they didn't pay the zakat. So okay, your information is completely wrong.
We're not, now we can't speak much.
Now we can't talk much. Okay, now let me get back to
the point. What happens to those who were not Muslims?
You know, this is
a Christian.
What happened? What happened?
Yeah, he's a Christian.
First Samuel.
What happened? What happened to those who did not pay?
Okay, first and foremost, guys, one at a time. Come on, one at a time. You know something? The Bible.
So you're telling me I should be happy that I have the option to either pay the tax?
Hello?
Or be killed.
No, it's not killed.
Or be converted.
No, it's not killed.
What kind of option is
that? That's wrong. I never said that option. I know you didn't.
It's right in the writings themselves.
Really? You know, you already got the three options. You know what the third option is? You missed out?
What's that?
Blood money.
What a joke.
Okay? So if somebody... For example, if somebody kills someone, they're not given an option to either just be killed and that's it. Okay? They got the other option of blood money. Which is if the family, the victim's family,
what
they decide...
What does it have to do with the point of the tax and conversion and not... What are you even...
Ah, about? You see, exactly. When I change the point, he has an objection. But when I was talking about Jesus, who is a God, and he's a mortal, he has no objection then.
Okay, so Islamophobe, by your definition, are people who are unjustly or... They're afraid of something without reason.
Yeah. I already gave you the answer for Islamophobia.
That's what you said. Islamophobia. Irrational fear of Islam.
And those people who are prejudiced just because somebody is a Muslim. Are you one of them?
That's not Islamophobia, my friend. No, that's ridiculous. There's individuals that you look at, but the writings themselves say three options.
No, the writings don't say three options.
Yes, they do.
And I corrected you.
They do, my friend. You know they do.
But I corrected you.
You know they do. What are three options? Okay.
Brother Hashim,
conversion.
In Islam, we have three options.
What is the option in Christianity? What are the options in Christianity?
Brother Hashim, one second.
What options?
In the Bible, what are the options?
In Christianity? You tell me.
In Bible, what are the options?
Where? What's the option?
In the Bible.
Leave to Caesar what is Caesar's. Leave to Caesar what is Caesar's.
Wait a minute. In the Gospel of Luke, yes, there's a parable about Jesus. Yes, bring my enemies in front of me, and if they do not believe in me, kill them. That is a parable about Jesus Christ.
Really?
Okay.
Really?
Do you know what Jesus Christ will do in the second coming? He's going to go to kiss the disbelievers. He's going to make them his footstools. He's going to kill them all.
What does that have to do with the point we were just talking
no,
about?
No, because you're saying, what are the options given?
Point of, we should be happy that we have the option to pay the tax. Otherwise, off with your head.
But what are the options Jesus
what
gives?
What are you talking about?
In the second coming, what are the options he's going to give? Either believe in me or die. Answer.
Really?
Yes, really.
Really?
Really.
So God is going to judge you is the same as a human judge.
No, not judge. This is judgment.
That's the final judgment.
No, it's not on the day of judgment. This is on the earth.
Yes, when he comes on the back earth. Is what you're saying.
Does he come as a human being or God?
No, you're saying the second coming, he will judge, and those who did wrong will die. This is according to what you're saying right now, right?
In the second coming.
That's what you're saying, right? And Jesus, according to Christians, is God.
Okay, so
hold on. This is God making judgment, as opposed to man.
And what do you think the Sharia comes from?
No.
Also from God.
But who's
thank you very much.
But who's enforcing it?
You see,
who's
when Jesus does it, who's enforcing it is God it? Saying it.
But who's enforcing it?
Oh, who's going to enforce the killings?
What killings?
You think Jesus is going to kill himself?
What killings?
You think he's going to kill himself? According to Revelations, he'll have an army. And who the armies are going to be, guys like him.
Guys like him are going to be the army.
Yes. And by the way, what about the Old Testament? Is it from Jesus as well?
My friend.
Is the Old Testament sanctioned by Jesus?
My friend, you right now, I'm a khabbis, as they say in Arabic, okay? Which I'm sure you don't understand.
Well, I'll make you hummus now in a minute. Just wait.
It'll be the best hummus you ever did.
Yes, and I can eat it with the khabs as well.
Yeah.
Okay, so let me ask you this. Do you believe?
Al-Adham, my friend. Al-Adham. Right,
trust me, hummus is much better mixed up than the khabs. So let me tell you this.
According to you,
we should be happy. Non-believers should be happy kafar. That they have the option to pay the tax. That's what you said.
And what about you?
That's
you don't even give any options in the Old Testament.
That's what you said.
In the Old Testament,
that's what you said.
Who fulfilled the command of killing babies?
About that.
Why not?
Who's enforcing that right now?
No, not right now.
Who's enforcing
not right now.
Who's
was enforcing? It? Do you agree to happen in the past?
Who's doing it now?
Do you disagree?
Who's enforcing it now?
Do you disagree?
And not only that, in the New Testament,
it's not even.
President Bush went to Iraq. New Testament, what?
Is George Bush in the Bible? Is he Jesus?
He follows the Bible.
What are you talking about?
When they asked him why he went to Iraq, he said, "My heavenly Father told me to."
Okay.
ISIS justifies everything they do direct out of the hadith in the Quran.
What you're saying, where?
From the newsletter they released.
But they're not our friends, are they?
Look at your reaction.
The ISIS are not our friends. They are our biggest enemies. They kill more Muslims than you guys.
Well, listen to what he just said.
He didn't. He did not suppose.
No, he just said, what about George Bush?
No, but wait a minute. First and foremost, we are not talking about George Bush only. We are talking about.
That's the point you were trying. You were trying to use George Bush as an argument.
Do you know that the New Testament says that all scripture is God breath, and all scripture is used for learning. All use is used for learning, gaining knowledge, and for applying it as well. Are you aware of that? So in the Old Testament, are you listening? In 1 Samuel 15:3, Jesus commanded.
It also says Muhammad.
Jesus commanded
said,
to kill every man, every female, every child. Do you know the Bible is the only book which
Muhammad commands that the Bible refer to them? He even said it himself.
No, he did not say that. Why don't you go right now? The Bible is the only book which talks about killing babies.
He's an Arab.
The only holy book which talks about killing babies is the Bible.
And donkeys.
No wonder he's running away.
And donkeys.
Looks like Mr. Hummus didn't like it. All right, guys. Jazakallah khair. This is what happens. You see when double standards take place, that you guys do this, you guys do that, you guys. But when we point the same thing towards their religion,
they walk away.
They don't. When he changed the topic, it was okay. When I changed the topic, it's not okay. Yes? I wanted to show him the passage from 1 Samuel 15:3, where he says to kill every male, every female, every child. And you know what? Not for the sins they committed. Not for because they attacked another country. It is because what their forefathers did something 400 years ago, their God is taking revenge. Remember this. God says it very clearly in both Numbers 31 and in 1 Samuel that it is for vengeance he's killing the women and the children and the animals as well. Even the animals are not spared. So these guys telling me that their religion teaches peace and love, no, it's not. Because they refuse to look what's in their own Bible. And this is not only in the Old Testament, even in the New Testament. If you look at Matthew 15, 3 and 4, it says Jesus is rebuking the Jews who have left their law. The law which says that you should kill, and this is the command of God, by the way, Jesus says. The command of God says, put to death anyone who curses the mother or father. That's in the New Testament, Matthew chapter 15, verse 3 and 4. Go home and read it. So this is the double standards we have to live with. They keep saying time and time again, Jesus is love. Christianity is love. It's anything but love. Today, most of the killings that happen in the world is because of the Christians. In particular, the reason for that is because they manufacture the largest ammunition of both weapons of mass destruction and nuclear arms.
You know
who has the biggest nuclear arms?
You know who?
Yes, bring him here. Bring him here right now. I'll debate him. Yes. If Jesus was here today, he will be appalled by Christians like him. Yes. Who actually says that Christianity is love when there is no love? They manufacture the largest arsenal of nuclear arms. And you know who's the only country which used nuclear arms on people? A Christian country like America. Against Japanese, yeah? Against Hiroshima and Nagasaki. They annihilated two cities. Just like 1 Samuel 15:3. Every male, every female, every child, even the animals. And they went one further than God even. The God of the Bible, they even killed the plants and every living thing in there. So you tell me, which religion other than the Christians is killing day in, day out today even? In Iraq, in Afghanistan, yes, in Syria, the Russians are bombing. In Pakistan as well, they are using the drones to kill innocent children and women. They would kill maybe one person they want to kill, but kill nine along civilians along with that. Yes, so this, to me, the largest arms manufacturers are the Christians. The largest arm manufacturers and their manufacture, their sales and their use is done by the Christians. And you know why? Many people will say, oh no, those armies are not Christians. Then maybe you should explain to us, why is there a cross when they die? In the cemeteries of the armies, you see them lying under a cross. Is that cross for decoration?
Capitalism.
Or did the families put it on them even though they were atheists? In that case, they would be desecrating their graves even. They did not even give them the last rites. Being atheists, they hoisted a cross on it. So you tell me who's doing the injustice. The Muslims or the non-Muslims? Having said that, I do not say there are no black sheep in Christian, in Islam. Of course there are. We have examples like the ISIS, yes, who consider themselves to be the Islamic State, yes, which no Muslims, at least not the sane ones that I know, recognize. And that is Majority of the Muslims oppose them. You know why? Because majority of the victims are Muslims. Yes? Majority of the people they kill are Muslims. How can they be our friends? Yes? The Prophet ﷺ said, be a Muslim is the brother of another Muslim. He never said to kill them. He never even said. In fact, the Quran says if you kill one man, regard, it doesn't say his faith or anything. If you kill one man, it is as if you kill the whole of mankind. And if you save one man, it is as if you save the whole of mankind. And alhamdulillah, with that I leave you brothers and sisters to look and ponder on the reality of who really is causing the terrorism today. The state terrorism that is being caused in Israel, killing poor Palestinian defenseless in a small place like Gaza. Yes? And you have these evangelists who come all the way from America and they sponsor them. They sponsor the settlers. They give them the money. Yes? So they can grab more land from Gaza and from the West Bank. And this is what we see. State terrorism is the worst kind of terrorism. Be it in Britain, be it in America, be it in Israel, be it in any place, any other place, is the worst kind of terrorism. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.